Access to endless amounts of information in the palm of our hands, or rather between our two thumbs, has its advantages. But where there is good, there's bound to be bad as well. Fox 9's Danny Beckstrom dives into some of the dangerous apps that your kids could be using regularly, despite the risk.
There are millions of apps out there. Some help make life a little easier, and of course you want to take advantage of those. But others just open the door for users to be taken advantage of.
You can only help navigate your child, but you have all these other influences that you won't have control of, and anything can come in.
Messaging apps like Kik, Yik Yak, and Ask FM encourage conversations from unverified accounts. Dehumanizing users, making it easy to bully or share pictures you otherwise wouldn't, tempting keyboard criminals.
It's a big problem within our culture, that's for sure. I mean, they have apps to hide apps these days, and there's one that's called KYMS, and it shows up on the iPhone as a calculator.
One of the most common apps to cause concern is Snapchat, an app that sends videos or pictures for 10 seconds or less before disappearing forever.
At least that's the theory. The problem is that anyone can screenshot it and save it forever.
That app is used for sexting, and a lot of young people will deny it. No, we don't do that. We just use it to send photos, and some people do.
The list of apps is long and getting longer every day, posing a new problem for parents of this generation who try to keep up with what their kids are carrying around in their pockets.
We're the first generation of parents to have to parent technology, so this isn't a thing that we can go ask our parents how they dealt with it with us, because they didn't.
What I learned is that the best way to protect your kids is to set boundaries early, raising your kids to know that you'll have full access to their accounts. But if your teen is already past this stage, make sure to ask them a few simple questions.
What are you getting from using this app? What are you disclosing? Think about your future. All those kind of things that get lost, and it's pretty automatic to just use the app.
And there are a few great resources out there for parents who want to find out more on this subject as well. First, the website commonsensemedia.org. There are reviews of apps as well as tips on how to deal with the dangers of social media. And your local police department and school counselors can also give you a better idea of the apps that pose a real threat to your child specifically.